We're human beings like everybody else. We like staying with family friends together. It is our way with the last 200 years or more, and leave us that way. We're not asking a lot.
Will you please tell me, what am I going to be? Living like a rat? Because that's the way they're treating us. Rats have got better lives at the moment in Dale Farm than we've got.
I understand we're on Greenbelt land, but put us into Brownbelt land and just leave us there. That's all we're ever asking any of the government, and we're pleading with the government.
I feel like crying the whole time over, but I just don't want to keep crying because I'm just going to make myself very badly depressed. I just keep sitting crying about it.
Nobody wants travellers on their back door. Nobody wants travellers as their neighbour. So that's the way it's going to stay being.
The High Court denied a last-ditch attempt by the residents of Dale Farm to stop the eviction of 86 traveller families who have made the former scrapyard in Essex their home for the past 10 years. However, they were given a glimmer of hope when Basildon Council was asked to provide assurances that those with poor health on the site would be cared for in the days leading up to the eviction. Candy Sheridan, a volunteer from the Gypsy Council, has taken it upon herself to collate a health audit of Dale Farm residents. She hopes that the council will delay the eviction until suitable accommodation is found for the sick and the vulnerable.
This is my head. Here, sit down. Are you all right? Give out the letters. These are from the hospital, Candy.
Oh, okay.
He's tending Basildon the whole time.
Okay, pleased to meet you. Hello. Candy Sheridan, I haven't met you before.
My main priority is my dad. At the moment, he's 80 years of age.
Yeah.
I cannot live without living with my dad and my sisters.
No,
we need one another's help. Dad helps me in my bad days, and they help me in my good days, and I help them.
Well,
and at all times, one of us have got to be with my dad.
I want to meet with social services and the primary care trust, and I want to be able to find out how they're going to look after your little cluster.
Yeah.
That's what I'm going to do.
All I need is before they take out the electricity and the water.
Yes.
We need electricity for my dad.
I know. This is the next thing. This is the next.
So this is what we want. I don't want to stay with everybody. If I understand, if Basildon want to split us up, they are willing to live here because I understand we've got to move.
Yeah.
Right. I understand there's never going to be the same as this again.
Okay.
I'm not going to roar, scream, hang our heads off of barriers.
No, good.
That has gone down nowhere.
So what I'm trying to do with this health audit is for where you, where for instance like yourselves, with your father being seriously ill, to talk to you about what will happen next. I can't stop it. You can't stop the way you are. I wear my heart on my sleeve. I do wish I hadn't been born, which has a strong social conscience. I do wish I could wake up in the morning and think I'm going to go shopping. I do wish I could get on with my life again and be an antique dealer and get on with some shows. It's nice to have little flashes of it. That's what I'd like. I'd like some of my life back again. But more than that, I'd like their lives back again.
On Monday morning,
yes.
I'm getting his every file that he have out of the doctor's surgery. I have to pay £55 for him.
So it's up to date. Okay.
So everything will be up to date.
And what's happening next?
If Basildon Council just want to give us a bit of waste ground, we'll build it up ourselves. We're not asking them for money. We're just asking them for somewhere to go, for us to go into a house, as everybody keeps saying.
It affects traveller health
affects
as well.
The health, not only the health. You'll put the kids to school. Oh, you're a gypsy. Your kids is getting bullied at school. Maybe your windies is getting broke.
This is the only security that these families have had. 10 years of security. It's not security. It's living with a police helicopter, endless enforcement notices, and they're vilified by the local press, by the national press. Some of the men can't get work. The women have suffered all sorts of racism, whether it's in shops or in pubs. That's not a type of life, but you know, it's still better than being on the roadside. Things were going well, but right up to the election, and when this coalition government came in, everything stopped. The message from Eric Pickles was very clear. You don't need to deliver for gypsies and travellers. And that was the end of it. And every single thing that's happened since under the coalition government has destroyed everything that my community needs everything.
Candy, he fell. He fell and cut his leg again by 10 paper stitches. 3 days later, he cried about his leg. Everything is so delayed.
But here on the site, everybody knows him.
And everybody watches out for him.
Yeah, so you've got all this lovely care.
He might spend 3 days crying that I can't even get to cook a bit of food.
Yeah.
That my friends will come in,
help,
they will cook, someone will take him by the hand. Then they know about him and they love him and they help me with him.
And then when Basildon say to you that the only choice now, which Tony Ball says, is for you to go to bricks and mortar and to a flat, how's that going to work for your boy when you open the door?
I would be so trapped. I think I would go in such a black hole, such a depression. And I've got good help here, Candy.
I know.
I have good help.
Well, I want to keep, that's what I want.
Yeah, and I was willing to give up all my time for the rest of his life just devoted to him. So I just want a bit of help.
All right.
Okay.
Oh, thank you.
You're going to say goodbye. You're going to say thank you?
No.
Are you good?
That sign?
It's good, yeah.
Good.
And he's learning sign.
It's a lot of distress here on people. They're saying the bailiffs is going to do nothing. I know they are going to do, because I've been down that road. They're saying they're not going to use force. They do use force. They're above the law.
This is what my job is now, is to take off some of you, if that's what you want, near the end, so that you don't face what you're going to face, because you know what you're going to face.
I know what they're going to
do. You know what you're going to do.
But I could come here, but they've got nowhere after here to go to.
It's just chaos here, isn't it? Everybody is in everybody's trailer, knocking on the doors, talking, are you okay? We've just been to see Kathleen, who had the baby, and she already had three or four residents in there. She had her relatives in there, her mother's outside, her father's outside, her grandfather's around the corner. You know, it's sort of real care in the community, not so-called care in the community. Nobody's done anything wrong at Del Farm. They bought a former scrapyard. They cleared it up. They've lived quietly. It cost the state nothing. There's no care homes here. There's no Meals on Wheels. I mean, I've been offered dinner now in about six different trailers. Everybody cares for each other. There's no childminders. What a lovely community. David Cameron, come and have a look.
Invited by the council to receive the eviction date, Candy arrives in Basildon to find the eviction details have already been leaked to a local paper.
I was given the complete undertaking and promise that I would be given the notices this morning with the date on. I would then be allowed to get back on site without a press release from Basildon. I would call a meeting, I would get the most vulnerable around, I'd visit them personally, and I would break the news gently to them if there's any way of breaking the eviction date. And that's what has been broken today, a complete lack of trust. Does it work anywhere? This slow, negotiated approach that I've been taking for years, has it reaped me any rewards? I can't think of anything, anyone. They did that on purpose. They did that to damage me and my status on the site and my, you know, it's to sort of destabilise the site as well. I always thought the system, because of the size of Del Farm, because of the vulnerability, the amount of elders, the amount of sickness, of cancer, young births, I thought somebody out there would see some sense. And it's not as if I'm saying to them, anybody, let them stay here. I've never said that. I said, I will actually get the residents off if you just tell me where they can go. And I found found places myself, and I've got valid planning applications, I've got public inquiry, and still they won't wait. Still they won't wait. Racist planning.
All right, we're just going to go inside, talk to the residents first, and then we'll certainly call a press release, but we just need to tell them first what's happening.
On her return to Dale Farm, Candy gathers the increasingly worried residents together to face the waiting cameras.
Today, this morning, Basildon Council have finally failed every resident that lives here.
The oldest member of the community is Daniel Sheridan, the great-grandfather of these children that cannot live without electricity because he's got a breathing oxygen mask. He's got all sorts. It is not fair to do this to an 80-year-old if they put him out in that road where he cannot get electricity, ambulance, exits to the hospital, you're going to have his death. That's how it's going to be.
And shame on Basildon that you can't wait a little bit longer and stop wasting £18 million because there's going to be deaths.
I rung Basildon Council less than 48 hours ago and asked about my homeless application form. I've been told it has not been looked at yet. I have four children, an 80-year-old man, a 76-year-old woman, a vulnerable sister with an infant living in one piece of ground with nowhere to go, and they're telling me they're not even looking at my application yet. So where are they putting me? Where are they putting me? I cannot tow. I've got no towing license. Dim notices says we can't even pull at the side of the road. So where do they want us to go? What do they expect us to do?
If the council were to offer you an alternative planners a pitch you would
all
leave
all of them would leave hastily. Every single resident is willing to leave.
One way I'll come out of town. Like my husband came out of it. Yeah. Dying down.
People are dying on this side.
Yeah. Well, I'm laying it. It's not council ground. I owned it. The Shelley, I've on it. I owned it. The council don't own it. No, I'm paying my council tax the same as everybody else around. I'm paying my light bill. And I can't see how that can come, because they'll take me out in a body bag out of my home. And I am not moving.
The first Shelley went. The first Shelley went yesterday. So this is the remains of it. The barricade is obviously from the activists trying to keep the bailiffs out, which is quite laughable. But this is where he's coming now, that man. We'll go this way. Oh. It can't put a chalet at the roadside. It's been sold to pay for a tourer. We'll probably end up with a situation on Monday when there's just a hardcore of people who can't drive, who can't tow, who don't want to go to the roadside, who don't have any relatives, who are on very heavy medication, or are waiting for a major hospital appointment, or even waiting for an operation. You're going to be left with the most vulnerable on Monday. Does it feel like Dell Farm to you anymore, Tina? What do you think?
It's like a funeral, isn't it?
It is, that's a good word. It's like a funeral. A truck has just pulled on full of English gypsies. They've picked up all the washing machines, and they just asked me who owns those big gates up there on that yard up there.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Yes.
So they must be wanting them as well.
Yeah. But they're cemented in, so they can't get them.
So they will want to buy them, do they?
I didn't think so. I didn't notice anyone paying for them. It feels like a war zone, but it feels like a funeral where nobody is bothering to come and pay their last respects.
Yeah.
Did you ever think that the day would finally come?
No, because I didn't think they'd ever get the money.
No.
I didn't think they'd ever get that kind of money and spend it so foolish. I'm just left wondering what'll happen when it's all over. What'll become of us?
This should be the last ever forceful eviction. That's what I want to happen. I want these women and these families to find safety and security. I want those children to go back to school. I want a lot of things. I just want them to have their lives again. I want their health to return. I want them to be treated as human beings. And I want this country to start embracing us as an ethnic minority. And let's get on with being part of 21st century Britain and the big society.